गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड इवनिंग सर।
सर
गुड इवनिंग। गुड इवनिंग। सो मॉर्निंग वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लूकोज एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ग्लूकोज। व्हाट ऑल थिंग्स वी डिड? वी हैव फाउंड द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला and we found the molecular formula to be C6H12O6. Then we have seen that it consists of six carbon which is linked in a straight chain. What was the reaction that shows that these carbon atoms are present in a straight chain? Which is the reaction that shows that carbon atoms are present in a straight chain?
Hydrolysis of salt with acid.
Is it hydrolysis of salt with acid? What is the salt?
Starch.
No. Glucose. We are talking about glucose. Sure. And we have seen that glucose is made of six carbons which are linked in a straight chain. Which reaction is showing that they are linked in a straight chain? With hydrogen iodide. On heating with hydrogen iodide. On heating with hydrogen iodide, it gives N-hexane. Which shows that six carbon atoms are linked in a straight chain. Okay. Now, we have also seen that they contain a carbonyl group. What was the reaction that shows the presence of carbonyl group? What was the reaction that shows the presence of a carbonyl group?
By the reaction with the hydroxylamine.
By the reaction with the hydroxylamine, it gives oxime, and on reaction with the hydrogen cyanide, it gives cyanohydrin. So this reaction shows that they contain a carbonyl group. Okay. Now, our next thing is to identify the type of the carbonyl group, identify the nature of the carbonyl group. Okay. And glucose is easily oxidized in presence of a mild oxidizing agent like a bromine water. If you are using a mild oxidizing agent, it will be easily getting oxidized to the monocarboxylic acid, which is known as gluconic acid. Okay, so next reaction. Glucose, when it is oxidized in presence of bromine water, it gives a monocarboxylic acid which is known as gluconic acid. Okay, it is a monocarboxylic acid. What is the meaning of monocarboxylic acid? What is the meaning of
single
a
single carbonyl group?
Not carbonyl group, carboxylic group. Acid group will be only one. Not carbonyl. Carbonyl is aldehydes and ketones generally are known as carbonyl compounds. And the carboxylic acid will not come under carbonyl compounds. Okay, even though it has the CO group, will not consider it as a carbonyl compound. Okay. Now, this reaction, that means shows that there is something in glucose which can be, it's a mild oxidizing agent. We have to water, bromine water is a mild oxidizing agent. So, if it is oxidized and it gives a gluconic acid, which is a carboxylic acid. So, there should be some group in the glucose which can be easily oxidized to a carboxylic acid. Okay. Alcohols can be oxidized to carboxylic acid, but it will not react with a mild oxidizing agent. And you can also see that thing that can be converted into carboxylic acid is aldehyde group. Okay, aldehydes on oxidation give carboxylic acid. Okay, and alcohols on oxidation will also give carboxylic acid. But this reaction will not be taking place in presence of mild oxidizing agent. Only aldehydes will be converted into carboxylic acid using a mild oxidizing agent. So what does this particular reaction indicate? What does this particular reaction indicate?
Presence of aldehyde.
Yeah, there should be a group other than alcoholic group which can be easily oxidized to carboxylic acid, which means that the carbonyl group in aldehyde should be in carbonyl group in glucose should be aldehyde, and it should not be ketone. Ketone cannot be oxidized, easily oxidized. Ketones are very difficult to oxidize. So this reaction, oxidation with the bromine water, gives a carboxylic acid COOH, CHOH four times, and CH2OH. So this particular compound is known as gluconic acid. This is known as gluconic acid. Okay, so oxidation with the bromine water indicates the presence of the carbonyl group, aldehyde group. The carbonyl group should be aldehyde group. Okay, now when it is acetylated, acetylation, that means introduction of an acetyl group, or we can simply say esterification. What should be esterification? What should be esterification reaction?
Formation of yeast.
Formation of an ester. Acetylation, we are introducing acetyl group by replacing hydrogen of the alcohol. So acetylation or esterification with the acetic anhydride. Acetylation with acetic anhydride gives pentacetate means 5 ester groups are produced. So this is the reaction. Glucose, when it is treated with acetic anhydride CH3CO two times O, it gives pentacetate of glucose. For esterification reaction, which are the functional group that take part in the esterification reaction? Which are the functional group that are taking part in the esterification reaction?
Normally
it will be a carboxylic acid group. Normally alcohol will react with carboxylic acid or anhydride. Okay, carboxylic acid or anhydride, or we can also say that acid halides. Those compounds that are containing acyl groups, they will give you an ester. Alcohol will give you an ester. So in this particular reaction, how many ester groups are produced? Yes. How many ester groups are produced? It forms pentacetate. It forms pentacetate. I told you pentacetate means there will be finally 5 ester groups produced. And the formation of pentacetate indicates the presence of 5 hydroxyl groups, and these hydroxyl groups should be on the different carbon atom. So this reaction, I'll write the reaction. Glucose, CHOH, CH2OH, CHOH four times. When it is treated with acetic anhydride, CH3CO, two times O. Actually, five molecules will react. What happens is hydrogen is replaced, hydrogen of the alcohol is replaced by acetyl group. So you'll get CHO, CH, O, hydrogen is replaced by CO, CH3 group. That is what we call as acetyl group. And this one, 4. And here, in the CH2, OH, hydrogen is there. That hydrogen is again replaced by CO, CH3 group. So this group, RCOOR, what do you call this RCOOR as?
Ester.
So here, how many ester linkages are formed? In this compound, how many are there? Here, four ester linkages, because OCOCH3 four times. So 4 plus 1, 5. So we say that pentacetate is formed. This is what we call as pentacetate of glucose. This is pentacetate of glucose. So what does this reaction indicate? Reaction shows that glucose should have five OH groups, and these groups should be on five different carbon atoms. This group should be on five different carbon atoms. Different carbon atom. Where do we say that there should be on five different carbon? For example, if we are having COH group on the same carbon, two OH group on the same carbon, it will be unstable and it will readily eliminate one water molecules to give the corresponding carbonyl compound. Okay, it will be unstable. Whenever two OH groups are on the same carbon, it will be unstable. But we know glucose is stable. Glucose is a stable molecule, therefore, even though 5 OH groups are present, we have already seen that there should be presence of 5 OH groups, and these 5 OH groups should be on 5 different carbon atoms because glucose is a stable molecule. Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
If you have got any doubts, you have to ask me. So these reactions, especially these reactions with the acetic anhydride, reaction with the HI, reaction with the bromine water, and one more reaction is the reaction with nitric acid. All these are very important. So you have to write and learn these reactions. Okay. So this reaction should indicate the presence of 5 OH groups, and these 5 OH groups should be on 5 different carbon atoms. Where do we say that they should be on 5 different carbon atoms?
Because if they are on the same, then they are really highly unstable.
It will become unstable and they will lose water molecules. So that is why we should be on the five different carbon atoms. So we have seen the presence of 5 OH group, 1 aldehyde group, okay, 6 carbon atom and 6 carbon atom in this straight chain. Okay, now one more thing, the last reaction with the nitric acid, reaction with the nitric acid. Glucose, when it is reacting with nitric acid, HNO3, you know, what is nitric acid? It's a very good oxidizing agent. Okay. Now, glucose, when it is oxidized using a strong oxidizing agent like a nitric acid, it gives gluconic acid. What was the first what was the previous one?
Bromine water.
Bromine water.
Bromine water, it gives gluconic acid. In nitric acid is not gluconic acid, it is saccharic acid. Sorry, it is saccharic acid. Saccharic acid, which is a dicarboxylic acid. A dicarboxylic acid. Okay. And I told you which are the groups that can be converted to carboxylic acid? Aldehyde can be oxidized.
Alcohol and acid.
Okay. Alcohol. And alcohol should be primary alcohol, not all alcohol. Primary alcohols can be oxidized to carboxylic acid. Okay. It can be oxidized to carboxylic acid. Not all. If it is a secondary alcohol, it will give you ketone. Not the carboxylic acid. It will not be easily oxidized to carboxylic acid. Secondary alcohols will be oxidized to a ketone and it will not give you carboxylic acid readily. Now, it gives a dicarboxylic acid. What is the meaning of that? Along with the aldehyde group, we have already seen the presence of aldehyde group. So aldehyde group is one carboxylic acid should be of the aldehyde. And there should be some other group in the alcohol which on reaction with a strong oxidizing agent will give a carboxylic acid. So what should be that group? It should be a primary alcohol. Okay. It should be a primary alcohol. What do you mean by a primary and secondary alcohol? How many primary alcoholic units are there in this glucose? How many primary alcoholic units are there?
One, sir.
This is a primary. And what about these four? What about these four?
2 degrees, sir. 4 degree alcohol.
Idea is secondary, not the 2 degrees, secondary alcohols. Okay. Secondary alcohols. And it shows this particular reaction shows that there should be some other group along with aldehyde which can be easily oxidized to carboxylic acid, and that should be a primary alcoholic group, and it shows the presence of primary alcoholic group and this one. So out of the five alcoholic groups, one should be a primary alcohol. So you will get a carboxylic acid here that will be converted to carboxylic acid, then CHOH. It cannot be easily oxidized. Okay. And there should be another primary alcoholic group which can be easily oxidized to carboxylic acid, a dicarboxylic acid, which is what we call saccharic acid. This is what we call as saccharic acid. Okay. So one primary alcoholic group, total five alcoholic group, one primary alcohol and four secondary alcohol, then one aldehyde group, six carbon atom in straight chain. These are the things which are there in the glucose. And based on these studies and some other chemical reactions, they have given the special arrangement of different groups in the glucose, and it was first given by Fischer, and we call it as Fischer projection formula. It was studied by Fischer, and he gave a configuration for the configuration of different carbon atoms for the glucose, and the configuration is like this. According to Fischer, we call it as Fischer projection formula, and he gave the CH and the special arrangement. We have seen that there are different groups, and he gave the special arrangement of different groups as well, like this. Then here it will be on the left hand, OH group is on the left hand side, it is hydrogen on the left right hand side, here again right hand side, fifth carbon again on the right hand side, and last carbon the final carbon should be a primary carbon. That means a CH2OH group. So he gave the structure of glucose like this. So this is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, and this is the sixth carbon. And if you look at this Fischer projection formula, six carbon atoms are there, which is in straight line. And on the third carbon, you can see that OH group is on the left hand side. In all other carbon, the OH group is on the right hand side. And in this case, you will see there are four asymmetric carbon atoms. Am I right? Four asymmetric carbon atoms which is linked with four different groups. Am I right or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. This is this one. This is the actual Fischer projection formula of glucose, and accordingly, we can give the structure of gluconic acid as COH, H, then COH, here H, then COH, this is H, again COH, this side it is H, and finally you'll have CH2OH. So this is what we call as gluconic acid, a monocarboxylic acid. And we can also give, this is obtained when glucose is oxidized with the bromine water. And we can also have the structure of this one, what you call the dicarboxylic acid, which is the saccharic acid. What should be the difference in saccharic acid? What should be saccharic acid?
Two carboxyl.
Yeah. You have a COH group at the beginning as well as at the end. You'll have this one at the beginning as well as at the end of the chain. So this is the formula given for saccharic acid. Saccharic acid, dicarboxylic acid. Okay. And glucose is normally given as is written as D plus glucose. It is the actual configuration of glucose, D plus glucose. Okay. D gives the configuration of the carbon atom. What do you mean by configuration? It gives the configuration of last asymmetric carbon. What do you mean by configuration?
Arrangement.
Arrangement. And this plus stands for, I told in the morning, what is this plus stands for?
Dextro.
That means optical rotation. It represents the optical rotation. It gives the optical rotation. And the glucose molecules will be dextro rotated. It will not be levo. It will be dextro. It will be always rotating the plane of the polarized light towards the right. So it is dextro rotatory, and it will have D configuration in the asymmetric carbon. So for assigning configuration, I will again write the structure of glucose here. CHO, COH, H, COH, H here, COH, H, again, COH, H, then CH2OH. Last one is CH2OH. Okay. Now, which is the last asymmetric carbon?
Third.
This is one. This is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, and sixth carbon. Five and six. And the asymmetric carbons are, this one is one of the acid carbon. Second one, when I represent star sign, it represent an asymmetric carbon. So four asymmetric carbons are there. Which is the last asymmetric carbon? The fifth carbon is the last asymmetric carbon. And the configuration of this carbon is compared with the glyceraldehyde. Okay. So I'll represent a glyceraldehyde. CHO, C, OH, H. Then you'll have CH2OH. CH2OH. And we call it as plus, plus glyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde. Why this plus? Because it is dextro. It is optically active. Asymmetric carbon is present. And you'll have minus glyceraldehyde also as well. Minus glyceraldehyde will have OH group in the left hand side. Plus will have on the right hand side. This is minus glyceraldehyde. Minus glyceraldehyde. In plus glyceraldehyde, it is the OH group is on the right hand side, and in minus glyceraldehyde, it is having OH group on the in the left hand side. And we will compare the configuration of the last asymmetric carbon with the asymmetric carbon of glyceraldehyde. And if it is on the right hand side, we'll give the configuration D. If it is on the right hand side, we'll give the configuration D. And if it is on the left hand side, just like this minus glyceraldehyde, it will be called as L, capital L. Are you getting or not? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
We are comparing last asymmetric carbon with the asymmetric carbon of glyceraldehyde. And here you can see that the configuration of the last asymmetric carbon is similar to plus glyceraldehyde. If it is similar to plus glyceraldehyde, we will give the configuration D. And if it is similar to minus glyceraldehyde, we will give the configuration L. Now you will be able to understand why it is given as plus D glyceraldehyde. Plus D glucose. Okay. Now, another thing is that even though this structure given by Fischer, it could explain most of the properties of the glucose, it could not explain many other properties, like it will not react with 2,4-D and P. It will not glucose as per the structure given by Fischer, it should react with 2,4-DNP, but glucose is not reacting with 2,4-DNP, which stands for dinitrophenyl hydrazine. It will not react. And 2,4-dinitrophenyl hydrazine is like this. And if we are having an aldehydic or a ketonic group, if you are having a carbonyl group, I am not representing the rest of this one. If you have this one, it should react with the 2,4. This is 2,4-DNP. And it should react with this NH2 group of phenylhydrazine. It should react with this one, and it should eliminate a water molecule like this, and you should have a product, double bond N, NH, double bond N, NH, then you have, should have a benzene ring, which is attached with NO2 and NO2. We'll call it as 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazone. Again, you'll study this one in the carbonyl chapter. So this is again a characteristic reaction of aldehyde ketones, reaction with the 2,4 DNP. But actually, glucose is not giving this reaction with the 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazine. And another characteristic reaction is that is of carbonyl compounds is that they will give addition products with sodium hydrogen sulfate. But glucose does not give addition reactions with NaHSO4, sodium bisulfite NaHSO3. They are not giving. Actually, if it is having a carbonyl group, especially aldehyde group, it should give both the reactions. A reaction with the 2,4 DNP and additional reaction with the sodium hydrogen sulfate. These are characteristic reactions of aldehyde groups, especially carbonyl groups, especially aldehyde groups. But glucose is not giving these reactions, which means that the aldehyde group in glucose is not completely free. These two reactions are indicating that the CHO group in glucose is not completely free. Is not completely free. Okay. And again, glucose is found to exist in two forms, alpha glucose and beta glucose. Glucose will be forming two forms, alpha and beta, and they are differing in their properties. Okay. And alpha form, it is having a specific rotation. Alpha will have a specific rotation. I told you what is specific rotation. Ability to rotate the plane of the polarized plate. Specific rotation is 111 degree. Beta form will have a specific rotation of 19.2 degree. 19.2. And if you take either of these, both are existing in crystalline forms. An alpha form will have a boiling point of 494. It will have a melting point of melting point of 419. Beta form will have a melting point of 423 Kelvin. 419 and 423. So two different forms. And these forms, if you are taking either alpha form or beta form, and if they are allowed, if you are taking the Rakow's solution and if it is allowed to stand for a particular amount of time, you can see that they will attain an equilibrium specific rotation of 52.7. Both will attain equilibrium value of 52.7, or we'll simply say approximately 52.7 degree. So if I am taking alpha form, it will decrease in specific rotation and it will become 52.7. And if you are taking beta form, it will increase the specific rotation and it will attain an equilibrium value 52.7. And this spontaneous this taking place on of on its own. This spontaneous change in specific rotation. When glucose is allowed to stand for some time, this is what we called as muta rotation. This known as muta rotation. And these facts could not be explained on the basis of the structure given by the Fisher open chain structure. We call the first initial structure, which was given as open chain structure. And this structure could not explain the open chain structure could not explain these chemical reactions. What are the chemical reactions I told you? One is their absence of reaction with sodium hydrogen sulfate. Their inability to react with the what is that? 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazine to form 2,4 dinitrophenyl hydrazone. Then when their aqueous solution is taken, when it is allowed to stand for an amount of time, you can see that they will attain an equilibrium specific rotation of 52.7. So these things could not be explained on the basis of the open strength structure. And to explain these facts, they proposed a high cyclic structure, and they found that this cyclic structure will be interchanging from one form to another form through the open chain structure. So we are going to discuss that one. Okay, so this is the thing. See here. Can you see this one? Can you see this reaction?
Yes, sir.
You can see that the first carbon aldehyde group is forming an oxide linkage with the OH group on the fifth carbon. The same is here. The only thing is the position of OH group. Here it is on the left hand side, this is on the right hand side. And this is what we call as heavy acetals. Again, you will study in that chapter. I will explain that reaction again. Okay. Now you see here, glucose. See a double bond O. Let me represent H here. Then you have C. OH, H, then C, OH, H, then C, OH, H, then you have C here, OH, and one H is there, then CH2OH. Now what happens is that there is a reaction like this. Aldehydes or carbonyl compounds, generally aldehydes or ketones, especially aldehydes, they will be reacting with alcohols. They will be reacting with alcohols. And when they react with alcohols, it will lead to the formation of an OH group on the carbon as well as an OR group on the carbon. And compounds having, what do you call this OR group? Alkoxy group. And OH group is known as alcoholic group, hydroxy group. Okay, hydroxy group. And if you have OH group and OR group on the same carbon, then they will be called as hemiacetal. And if they have two OR group on the same carbon, they will be called as the acetal. How a hemiacetal is formed? Tell me how hemiacetal is formed.
Carbon attached with one OR group.
Ah, yeah. alcohol will react with the carbonyl group. Alcohol should react with the carbonyl group, and as a result, you will have the formation of OH group as well as OR group, alcohol group as well as alkoxy group on the same carbon. Then that will lead to the formation of hemi. That compounds will be known as hemiacetals. Okay. Now here, if you take the glucose, here glucose you have the carbonyl group and we have the alcoholic group. This OH, this carbonyl group will interact with the OH group on the fifth carbon. This OH group. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it will interact with the carbonyl group of the fifth carbon and it will form a cyclic compound. So here it forms like this, CH. And what should happen for this double bond O? What should happen for double bond O? It will come, it will be converted as OH group. Okay. And the second carbon, this is now, this is the first carbon, second carbon, there won't be any change as such. Third carbon, there won't be any change as such. Fourth carbon, there will not be any change, it will remain as such. Fifth carbon, you have the OH group. Out of that OH group, oxygen will interact with the carbonyl group and that will lead to the formation of the oxygen linkage. So I can call it as this is OR, this ring is forming OR, the other part is OH. So cyclic structure is formed. How many members are in this cyclic structure? How many atoms are involved in the cycle formation? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon and one oxygen. So it will form a six membered ring is formed out of that 5 carbon atom and 1 oxygen atom. And in this case, you have OH group on the right hand side. So we call it as alpha form. If OH group is on the right hand side, we call it as alpha form. Similarly, when it is forming a hemiacetal, the OH group can be on the left hand side. OH group can be on the left hand side. Then COH, H, COH, H, COH, H, then C, H, oxygen is linked with the first carbon through an oxide linkage. And last carbon is CH2OH. And this will be called as beta form. Beta form. And the first carbon now becomes an asymmetric carbon. So it becomes an anomeric carbon. It becomes anomeric. Where if there is a difference in the configuration of OH group on either side on the first carbon, then we will call it as an anomeric carbon. And these two alpha and beta forms are known as anomers. Alpha and beta forms are known as anomers. So you will be wondering, what are anomers? Can you now tell me what will be an anomer? Can you tell me what are anomers?
Sir, different arrangement in C1 carbon.
Yeah. Anomers are nothing but they are optical isomers. Optical isomers. Which will differ in the configuration of, which differs in the configuration, configuration of C1 first carbon. Optical isomers that differ in the configuration of first carbon, they will be known as anomers. So you will have two cyclic forms which will be called as alpha form and beta form. And as I told you, when alpha form is taken, alpha form will become open chain structure, then it will be converted into beta form. And if you are taking beta form through the open chain structure, it will be converted into alpha form. And at equilibrium, they will have a net specific rotation of 52.7. So one form will be automatically getting converted into another form, and they will till they attain equilibrium. So that is what the optical specific rotation changes, and it attains a value of 52.7. Okay. So these cyclic forms are they gave the cyclic forms, okay, and how this glucose can be called as beta, which differs in the configuration of anomeric carbon. D stands for the configuration of the cyclastic carbon, and plus, which stands for the optical activity, and glucose. This is the actual name of glucose for this structure. So what should be this one then? This is alpha, then D, then you should have plus, then glucose. This is the name of the second anomer of glucose. Okay. And this cyclic structure will differ in the configuration of the anomeric carbon, and they are forming a six-membered ring structure, and this ring structure is also known as pirano structure. This ring structure will be known as pirano structure. With analogy to piranos or piran, which with analogy to piran and organic compound piran. This compound is known as piran. So the cyclic structure of this one will be called as pirano structure. And this pirano structure can be properly given by another scientist known as Haworth. Haworth gave the actual pirano structure of glucose. Okay, now I am going to write this cyclic structure. I will explain how it is written. Alpha form, I will represent COH, H, then COH, H, COH, H, COH, H, then you have C, H, and it is forming a ring with the first carbon, anomeric carbon, through an oxygen, and last carbon will be CH2OH. And I will number it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now let us see how we will convert this one into pirano structure. I'll first write the six member ring. Okay. Here one oxygen. So I wrote the six member ring. And this position, this is first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon. You'll have fifth carbon here. And one more carbon, last carbon, will be at this position, CH2OH. CH2OH, this is the sixth carbon. Now, you are going to give the substituents at each of the carbon. Bonds are shown with the line. Okay. Whenever OH group is at the right-hand side, you put it below the line. And whenever OH group is on the left-hand side, you put it at the top of the line. You take a look at the first carbon. OH group is on the left hand side, sorry, on the right hand side. So I am writing on the bottom. Okay, the other group is hydrogen, is written at the top. Second carbon, you have OH group on the right hand side. Again, it will be written at the bottom, then hydrogen at the top. If you take the third carbon, OH is on the left, so it should be at the top, then hydrogen is at the bottom. fourth carbon, it is again right, so it is at the bottom and top. Fifth carbon, oxygen, it is attached with oxygen, this bond. And sixth carbon, CH2OH. So this is which form? Alpha D gluco D plus. D plus, we call it as glucopyranose. Pyranose, because it has a pyranose structure. Alpha D glucopyranose. Any doubts regarding writing the structure? In Haworth representation. This is what we call as pyranose structure. Any doubt?
So repeat once.
Did you get this cyclic structure?
So no, writing yes, over subduction confusing.
No, sir. Which is confusing?
H and OH groups, sir, which one to write up and down.
Yeah. So first you will write a structure similar to pyranose. We will not consider double bond. All other things will be written. Okay. So you are having a six-membered ring is first written with analogy to second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, and here you'll have fifth carbon, and fifth carbon will be attached with, this is the fifth carbon attached with one oxygen, and it is attached with one hydrogen and one CH2OH. Okay, so on the fifth carbon, it is attached with oxygen is already shown. It is attached with the hydrogen and CH2OH will be always written at the top, and it forms the sixth carbon. Okay. Understood this much?
Yes, sir.
This much? Yeah. Now, whatever groups is coming on the right hand side in the cyclic structure, you put it at the bottom of the line, bottom of the bond. And whatever is on the left, you put it at the top. So you take the first carbon, which is on the right?
OH.
So we are writing at the bottom. Hydrogen is on the left, you write at the top. Second carbon, OH, is at the right, again at the bottom. Hydrogen is at the top. Third carbon, OH, is on the left and hydrogen is on the right. So hydrogen bottom and OH at the top. Fourth carbon, again OH at the bottom. And hydrogen at the top, because left and right and left. And sixth carbon already we wrote. Understood?
Fifth carbon, hydrogen will come on top. Fifth carbon,
this is fifth carbon. You look at the fifth carbon. It is attached with the oxygen through a ring. So this oxygen is already there. Okay. And it is attached with the hydrogen. Okay. And always you are how to write the CH2 group that at the top. CH2 group should be always coming at the top. So CH2OH is as position is fixed, and therefore hydrogen will be at the bottom.
Yes, sir.
Understood. So yes, this is, so what will be the difference in beta D glucopyranose? What is the difference in beta? Instead of this OH, where will you have the OH group? A first carbon. At the top, what will you have? If I write OH at the top and hydrogen at the bottom, then what is this for?
Beta.
This becomes
glucopyranose.
D. Glucopyranose. So this is what we call as pyranose form, which is represented by Haworth. Okay, I will show it. So this is the two structures I told you, and you can also see the cyclic structures where alpha form has OH group at the bottom. Wherever you can see this, you compare these two structures. Sorry. You compare these two structures. Wherever OH is on the right, it is at the bottom, wherever left is the top. So if you are taking alpha form, this is alpha form, first carbon OH is on the right. So this is anomeric carbon, first carbon OH is on the right. So it is at the bottom, second carbon on the right bottom, third carbon on the left top, fourth carbon bottom, fifth carbon, it is fixed to CH2OH and H. Same is the case with the beta. Here, OH at the top, then rest of will remain same. Rest of the groups will be same. This is Haworth representation. Okay. Haworth representation of glucose. So you should know how to write the structures of alpha D glucopyranose as well as beta D glucose. This structure, writing the structure, you should learn. Earlier, once it was asked to write the structure of glucose in the pyranose form. So you should be able to write. No need of byharting, only if you know the configuration, you will be able to do that one. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So with that, so one more thing was there. I thought of completing fructose also. So anyway, fructose we'll discuss tomorrow. So with the structure of glucose, we'll wind up our class for the day. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.